You know, this is all very, very weird.
What?
Well, I'm used to having an argument in the morning during breakfast, and now that it's all quiet, I just kind of feel like we're missing something.
This family doesn't argue. We merely exchange opinions in a very spirited manner.
Well, thank you for clearing that up. I feel a lot better.
The reason it is so quiet this morning, Emily, is because Carly is upstairs with morning sickness. Probably the only positive thing that's come out of this pregnancy.
You know, there's still a chance that we can keep this whole thing under wraps. Nobody outside the family needs to know that Carly is carrying Sonny's child.
Emily?
I thought that everybody at Kelly's knew.
Did you tell them?
What's the difference? Well, we can't control what Sonny does. He's bound to tell someone.
Oh, it really doesn't matter anyway. What does count is that we keep Sonny away from Michael so that he has no claim whatsoever to the child that he's having with Carly.
I don't see how that's possible. If he's the father, he has certain rights.
If you're going to contradict me, Alan, then just stay out of it. And that includes the rest of you, too.
Edward, please, let's not turn this into another war between ourselves.
Excuse me, sir. This has just arrived for Carly.
Oh, thank you, Sally. Here, well done. You can take that if you will, please.
You can't open that, Father. It's Carly's.
But I instructed the staff to bring all of her mail and messages directly to me.
Grandmother, I think it's illegal to do that, to open someone's mail.
Sonny Corinthos pays no attention to the law, so why should we? Whatever he has up his sleeve, we must be prepared. Uh-huh. He's wasted no time. Here it is. A court order for a paternity test.